For very aggressive patients, Pinel recommends working with a minimal team of four. Each member attaches a universal limb belt with a lock. Begin by determining an attachment point that is solid and moves with the upper surface of the stretcher when it is raised or lowered. Do not attach the belt to the bed rails or other parts that impede stretcher operations. The long end of the limb belt allows connections to multiple points along the stretcher or bed. Place the locks and keys at each end of the stretcher so that every team member knows their location. Remove the Velcro covers and place them on the black Velcro patch on the bag. This ensures that the Velcro covers will be replaced on the limb belt prior to storage and washing. Lay the cuffs on the stretcher or bed in the proper position to connect to the patient. The cuffs should be far enough apart that the patient can't reach across or touch them, but close enough that you can link them in the middle if needed. In order to reduce patient vulnerability, the ankle cuffs should be secured close together. Tighten the long strap and insert the pin and lock with the button. Ensure that the button is facing outward to allow easy opening. Tuck the limb belts under the mattress for rapid retrieval and to reduce patient trauma when approaching the stretcher. Place the torso control belt at the head of the stretcher, where the team leader will be positioned. For surprise visits and to speed up application, keep the long end of the limb belt connected and ready to go. You can simply attach the long portions of the straps together and pass them under the stretcher to the team member on the opposite side. For all procedures, adjust the stretcher to its lowest position and lock the brakes for patient loading. The stretcher is now ready for the patient. Warning: the patient should be monitored at all times, and the stretcher side rail should always be in the up position,